Have you ever wondered why we bond neutrals and grounds together at electrical services? There's a reason why we put our neutrals and our grounds together out at the service. So first, let's get into what grounding and bonding are. First, when we talk about grounds or grounding, that is literally just means we're intentionally taking something and connecting it to earth. Bonding is just taking two things and connecting them to make them one. Now, why do we bond electrical systems to neutral and ground? First of all, we need a way to clear a fault if there is a fault condition. So how a breaker works typically is as current comes from a transformer down, we'll say the black conductor, goes through the breaker at the service panel, through the black conductor out into the field to a load, like a say a light bulb, goes through the light bulb, comes back on the neutral, through that panel and goes back up to where it came from. It goes from the source all the way through the system back to the source. That is how a circuit works. And if too much current happens or something happens all of a sudden, that breaker will sense, because it's in the middle of a circuit, in the middle of a complete loop, it'll sense that there's a problem and it will cut the circuit off. Let's say we have a light fixture that same light bulb was on before. And for some reason, the black conductor that is hot, that's live right now, all of a sudden like breaks off and touches the metal of that fixture. What's gonna happen? Well, if we don't have the neutral and the grounds bonded together, the ground, the metal piece of equipment, even though it has a ground wire going to it, doesn't have a return path. If you follow the ground wire, you know, say we've got our black wire goes through here, we've got this piece of metal, the piece of metal is around the fixture is attached to the ground wire, and the ground wire goes back into the panel and lands on the bus inside of here. But how does that metal bus, that strap, attach to bring current back up to the source to allow that full circuit to flow for there to know that there's a problem to trip that breaker? There isn't one. So we have to bond the neutral and the ground together so that we can give a return path and complete the circuit to let that breaker know, hey, there's a problem, we need to trip the breaker. So ground fault technology, arc fault technology, any kind of breaker, all of it works on the premise that we need a complete circuit for current to flow through it. Flow through it in large amounts or small amounts or anything, but it has to flow. And the only way that a circuit is going to flow, current's going to flow, is if we have a complete circuit from a source all the way back to a source. That's the reason that we put the neutral and the ground together.